All right, let's take a little look-see here. Current sale price for used Canon cameras and lenses. Just kidding. I can't sell my cameras, but I do have a new camera here in my studio, and I think it's gonna be my new best friend. By the way, this video is being sponsored by the great people over at the online learning community, Skillshare, but more on that in just a second. I gotta get to my brand new camera here, the Fujifilm X-T3. Now, I've done reviews before, but I haven't actually done a camera review on this channel, so I'm pretty excited. I just got this camera a couple of days ago. I know it came out 6 to 7 months ago, but for me in 2019, there were a couple of cameras that were contenders, but the X-T3 remained at the top of that list for video and for photography, and I wanna tell you why, but I actually haven't shot with this camera yet. I just got it, so I haven't made any shots, so everything you see in this video is gonna be the first shots that I make with this camera. So let's get to shooting. Where to start off? I guess first off I want to say that I bought this camera, so Fujifilm is in no way sponsoring this review or paying me to say anything I'm about to say, but I was a Fujifilm X photographer in the past. I'm not anymore. However, I do know their camera systems. I love their cameras, and maybe one day I will be a photographer for them again in the future. Who knows? But for now, I want to start off by saying what I was looking for in a camera when I bought the X-T3. I have a stills camera. It's the Canon 5DS. It's filming me right now. It's a 50 megapixel beast with loads of great features for a studio guy like me. I mean, I love it, but it sucks at video, which is fine because I'm not a professional video shooter. I'm a stills guy, but more and more as times are changing, I'm finding that I want to add video to my bag. So I was looking for a camera that had some amazing video, you know, capabilities. And let me tell you, the X-T3 is pretty amazing for under $1,400. The X-T3 will shoot video in 4K at 24 and 60 frames per second for a little 4K slow-mo, and it'll shoot this at up to 400 megabytes per second in 8 and 10 bit, which is a huge amount of detail. The X-T3 has full HD high-speed recording at 120 frames per second in 10 bit as well to capture all those drips and splashes and even slower motion. There's F-Log and HLG, a flat profile for a better color grade. However, I don't really need that, but I'll get to that later. Then there is the ever popular Fuji Eterna film simulation, which is pretty cool. Plus, it's a nice little stills camera. However, with all of that, it still was a difficult decision to make. In 2019, there's a ton of great cameras to have if you're looking for something video-centric. I was stuck between this camera and the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K, that's a long name, and the Panasonic GH5S. All three cameras are great on paper. They all had very similar specs, so it was a difficult decision. I would probably have the Blackmagic camera sitting here in front of you today if it wasn't for the fact that it's backordered everywhere I looked. And I almost pulled the trigger on the Panasonic GH5. However, all of the reviews in the deep, dark, dungeonous pit of review sites that I was reading had this camera, the X-T3, beating it in autofocus and, of course, sensor size. But hey, before you go kill me in the comments section, that's just what they said. Over there, they're right over there. Bring the pain. The images coming out of the X-T3 are extremely sharp with this beautiful steely quality to the colors. Both of these images were shot using my Elechrome studio lights and my Fuji 35mm f1.4 lens. Even though it takes some rockin' still images, I didn't buy it for that. No, the X-T3 will be my new camera for food videos. One thing that was absolutely essential in my hunt for a new camera was that I had to be able to adapt my Canon lenses to it. Now, Micro Four Thirds cameras like the Panasonic GH5 and the Blackmagic, they have a ton of great adapters for them, like Metabones and Speed Boosters, but for Fuji, not so much. So I spent some time and I finally found the Fringer EF to FX Pro 2, which had some pretty good reviews. It's not a speed booster, but it is a smart adapter and has a nice aperture ring, just like the Fuji lenses. The X-T3 has an APS-C size sensor, which has a 1.5 times crop, which makes that 24mm Canon lens that's recording me right now have a frame size more comparable to a 35mm attached to my full-frame Canon 5DS. I was curious to test out the X-T3's continuous autofocus with a variety of lenses, like this Fuji 35mm and my Canon lenses adapted with the Fringer Pro 2. Now, I noticed that the 100mm hunts a lot, but it's sharp when it finds me, and my 50mm lens does really well keeping me in focus throughout the frame. Shooting video in HLG and F-Log took some getting used to for me, and I don't really believe it's truly necessary to shoot in those color profiles here in my studio environment. However, I did see a huge potential for some deep color grading. In my assessment, the HLG 10-bit H.265 has a deeper color richness to it right out of the gate. While I found the F-Log to be a little bit flatter, producing a less contrasty image, even when using the same color correction in post. You don't get as much range to work with the colors in post using their standard video profile, but it's sure a lot faster to edit with. I'm no professional color grader. However, Fujifilm does provide some free downloadable LUTs that you can use with your video, including their popular Eterna film simulation. For me, however, this is really just a moot point. I don't need to shoot in F-Log or HLG as I'm controlling the lighting here in my studio, so I don't end up needing to do that much in post. I have this older computer. It's a MacBook Pro from 2012. It's all spec'd out, but boy, do these files just crush my computer. Shooting in log is great when you need to get the most out of your camera's dynamic range during the editing phase. But since I'm controlling my lighting here in the studio, it's really easy to keep my highlights and my shadows in those acceptable ranges. I don't need to do much color correction. Will I use F-Log or HLG in the future for my food videos? I mean, maybe, maybe not. It depends on how quick of a turnaround I need to make for my production. But I'm really excited to learn more in this arena. The feature that I'm most excited about with the X-T3 is the massive full HD 120 frames per second in 10-bit. For all of those slow-mo food shots that I've just been dying to make in my food videos, there is a slight crop when using this mode, but it's not that bad. However, it does increase your shutter speed to 1/120th automatically. I've never had a camera that can shoot 120 frames per second before. I mean, I understand why it increases the shutter speed, but it did catch me off guard a couple of times. Like I was saying, these H.265 files were putting quite the tax on my laptop, but I found that if I transcoded them to ProRes 422 using DaVinci Resolve, which is a free download, they played back fine when it came time to edit them. Downloading the Fujifilm LUTs makes color grading quick and easy when shooting in F-Log or HLG. The Eterna LUT looks really good right out of the box without any other color correction needed. One thing that I really like is that Fujifilm allows you to pretty much customize every button on the camera, so I've played around with that. Setting up the front button here to select my autofocus points and this top little button to select the high-speed recording settings so I can quickly capture some slow-mo without having to go into the menu. I'm not a big fan of how the menu is laid out, but one cool feature that I really like is that Fuji allowed you to save custom menu items into a section called My Menu, where I fitted it out with all the video features I want access to, like movie mode, the time-lapse function, audio settings, F-Log and HLG, and all of that stuff is right there with easy access to it, just the press of one button. And I don't have to fumble around through a million menu items. I did just a quick ISO test with the X-T3 and it's pretty good in my studio environment here. I didn't really start to notice any noise until getting up to around 6400. Then you start to get this noisy snow effect around 25,600. However, for me, I doubt the ISO will ever get past 1,000. I don't really mind that it doesn't have a flippy screen. I mean, I would prefer if it flipped out this way so I could see what I'm recording, but I've survived this long without one. The overall camera design, however, is still a little bit too small for me, but that's how they've always been. This is really the first piece in a growing line of gear that I want to get to create the ultimate video setup for the type of videos that I want to create, which brings me to the great people over at Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of classes, dozens of which are covering creative and entrepreneurial skills. You can explore classes in everything from photography to creative writing to marketing, productivity, and just so much more. Premium membership gives you unlimited access to all of these great classes conducted by experts in their field. Skillshare is also incredibly affordable, with an annual membership costing you less than $10 a month. I'm diving into the DIY cinematography class right now, taught by Ryan Booth. He did a documentary feature commissioned by the director of the movie The Revenant, which is pretty awesome in its own right. And there's just a ton of great tips in his class about working with and shaping that natural light. And I really love his personal take on creating that cinematic look to your work. So click on that link in the description below to get yourself a 2-month free trial of Skillshare Premium. But hey, do you like the X-T3? Have you bought it yet? If so, do you like it? Do you not like it? Let me know, but I'm excited to be up in my video game. But as always, if you like this video, please hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, give it some thumbs up, show some love, drop some comments down below, and I'll see you in the next one.